DCI Howard Groves is leading an international cold case murder inquiry, the first of its kind, into the deaths of Paula Fields and Melissa Halstead. His chief suspect is John Sweeney, currently in prison, but eligible soon to apply for parole. His crime was the attempted murder of another girlfriend, Delia Barmer. The attack was in 1994, but Sweeney was only caught and convicted in 2001.
He got a life sentence, at least 13 years. Delia Barmer was a nurse by profession, and it would appear as if that relationship was volatile and violent. We know that on at least two or three occasions during his time with her, he had attacked her, assaulted her, threatened her. In fact, on one occasion, he tied her to a bed and played Russian roulette with her with a pistol.
To help bolster their case against Sweeney for the murders of Melissa and Paula, detectives revisit the evidence of Sweeney's vicious attacks on Delia Barmer.
What I would describe as a goodie bag is recovered that we know belonged to Sweeney. You have a bag that contains plastic sheets. It contains duct tape. It contains a rope. It contained a saw, as well as scouring pads and a change of clothing.
At the time, these were thought to be the legitimate tools of Sweeney's trade as a carpenter.
You can only look at it in the context of the bigger picture later on in relation to Melissa Halstead and Paula Fields. It would be, why has he got them? Strange man. Was he likely to have killed her? That may very well have been the case. But hindsight's a great thing.
Delia Barmer barely survived Sweeney's last assault with an axe on her front doorstep. Afterwards, she revealed to police that during their time together, he'd threatened her with his murderous past.
He actually confessed to her that he had killed a girlfriend of his who was American. So pretty early on, he actually confessed at the time to killing Melissa.
But in 1994, Melissa was still an anonymous victim, and Sweeney hadn't yet met Paula. In 1990, there had been no means of identifying Melissa Halstead as John Sweeney's first victim. 11 years later, in 2001, despite strong suspicions of Sweeney's guilt, there was insufficient eyewitness or forensic evidence to charge him with Paula Fields' murder. But in trying to build that case, police did find chilling evidence of Sweeney's disturbed state of mind.
There was a lot of artwork that was recovered from John Sweeney's premises in 2001. There were carvings, paintings, and poetry.
In Sweeney's flat, and at his mother's home in West Lancashire, police discovered more than 200 paintings and poems. As Howard's team returns to the Sweeney archive, they are able to make a chilling connection between what he painted and the two murders they are now reinvestigating.
It was obviously a meticulous process of going through all of those. I'd be in my office and my colleagues would come in to me and say, "Gov, look at this artwork. We think that that refers to Melissa. Gov, got this bit of artwork we think that relates to Paula." Obviously, those like eureka moments, we were thinking, that's the bit we want. And one in particular was called One Man Band, and it was basically an autobiographical, sort of confessional account of places that he'd been throughout the years. Part of it with Melissa Halstead. But it was apparent that he'd obviously tip-exed, or someone had tip-exed out one of those sketches. And we obviously submitted that for forensication. And it then became apparent that it had like a tombstone. And on the tombstone, it said, "Melissa Halstead, born with her date written in it and then said died with a question mark. Why is it that he would want to hide that little sketch when you consider everything else within the artwork hadn't been touched? And it was significant because it would meant that at some point he knew that she had died, even before those remains had been identified. Goodnight Vienna was basically a depiction of a duffel bag appearing as if he's got an object inside of it. Now that's significant because Melissa's remains are recovered from an army duffel bag.
In addition to the lurid drawings, Sweeney's writing is loaded with clues that only now make sense.
One of the verses gave an autobiographical account of his time with Melissa. It starts about meeting her in London, which we know is where they met. Then there's another account about blood spilled in Vienna, where we know that that's where a significant assault took place against Melissa. He later on then talks about at some point we'll be as one, which was well before Melissa's remains were identified. He's obviously implying that she was dead, and the only time you can be as one is if he had also killed himself. Every single line was an accurate account of his experience and his relationship with Melissa. You couldn't have gotten a better confessional evidence. Another bit of damning evidence that was found was a scratch card, and on that scratch card it made reference to poor Melissa, chopped her up in bits, food to feed the fish, Amsterdam were the pits. Well, we know from that account she was chopped up in bits, and she was in essence food to feed the fish because she was placed in the canal. And we know that Amsterdam was a pit because that's probably where he killed her. So that yet again was some more damning significant evidence.
Pictures that appear to reference Paula Field's murder are equally chilling.
One of them depicts a naked female in what I would describe as sort of a crouched position, with her thighs close to her chest. Now, if you think back to Paula Field's case, when she was recovered, she didn't have her hands, her feet, or her head. So we surmise from that 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 was obviously depicting Paula Field's.
In 2001, without corroborating evidence, this gruesome picture was not enough to implicate Sweeney in Paula's murder. But now, 9 years later, Howard's team makes a sickening discovery. In prison, Sweeney is still drawing. And one picture in particular appears again to reference Paula.
The artwork shows the dismembered remains as if somebody put them all back in the correct order. It's just a macabre sort of way to depict anyone. And therefore, what are the chances of all of this artwork that we have and verses and him not being responsible for the murder of Melissa and Porter?